You've just shot your own video. Now, how do you edit the video? Do you need to download complicated desktop software, or is it possible to just edit it on your phone? When it comes to video, shooting the video is just part one. Part two is editing the video, and it's a part that can be confusing and a little intimidating. And in this episode, I'm going to dispel some of the confusion and give you three specific tools to edit your video and get it online so people can see it. Sound like a plan? Stick around. Video can help you grow your business, but you need a plan. You're listening to The Video Strategist, a podcast to help you plan the video you need to get the results you want. Stick around for video marketing advice designed to move the needle for your business. If you've done any amount of browsing online for what app or software to edit your video, you've probably already come across Adobe Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro. Both of these programs are pretty industry standard. They are the go-to software of choice for most video editors, including myself. I'm personally familiar with both and have used both, but you don't necessarily need to use either one. And it's not because I don't think you're capable of learning to use them. It's just because they can be costly in both time and money. And I think we can both agree time is often money. So, is there a more cost-effective and time-efficient way to edit your videos? Yes, there is. But as is the case for most of these questions, the answer is also, it depends. It depends on how you're shooting your video, as well as your own expectations for the end result. What do you want your video to look like when you're finished with it? When it comes to video editing, you should be shooting your video with the edit in mind. The more intentional you can be on the video shoot side, the less work you'll actually need to do on the editing side. The simpler your video, the simpler your edit. Make sense? The more you get things right while shooting your video, specifically things like your lighting, your audio, and composition or camera angle, the less you'll need to actually edit, if anything at all. Let me pause here for a moment and let you know there is absolutely nothing wrong with a single shot talking head style video. Don't think of this as lazy video making. It can be if you're not putting any thought into it, but if you are putting thought into it and you're being strategic about it and specific with your message, it can be one of the most effective video styles, not to mention one of the best ways to humanize your brand and make your business more relatable and approachable. It may be simple, but there is nothing wrong with simple. In fact, if anything, simple allows you to create more content and help that content go further. I'll cover some best practices for this style of video in future episodes, but for now, let's assume this is the type of video you're shooting and get back to how to actually edit it. Once you've shot your footage, it's time to import it into a video editor tool. Now, there are two ways you could go about this, a desktop program or a smartphone app. I'm going to assume you shot your video on your phone, which is probably one of the most popular ways to do that. Since the video is already on your phone, the easiest situation is to just import that footage into the video editing app on the same phone. Now, there are a lot of apps for this on the market, as you can imagine. If you can't tell by now, I like to keep things simple. And as an iPhone user, my go-to video editing app of choice is iMovie. When it comes to making quick and easy cuts to video that I've shot on my iPhone, I found iMovie to be a clean workspace that lets me quickly and easily make all the cuts that I need in my video. I can make a few adjustments and even add in some background music if I want, but it does just what I need it to do. And even better, it's free. A lot of other video editing apps for smartphones are going to be free to download, but then they prompt you to make in-app purchases for other features. I get it, and sometimes it's worth it, but let's be honest, kind of drives me a little nuts, and I'm sure it does you as well. iMovie also has a desktop app for Mac users if that's where you would prefer to do your video editing. And Mac users can use AirDrop to quickly download the video from your iPhone to your MacBook. However, I prefer the iMovie app on my iPhone just because of how easy it is to use. And again, my video is already on my device, so it's literally just a matter of starting a new project, importing, and editing it. Okay, but what if you're not an iPhone user? What? Why wouldn't you use an iPhone? Just kidding. I know there are plenty of Android users out there, and you've got some good options for you as well. Check out the Adobe Rush app, which is a video editing app by Adobe specifically for online video creators. It's also available to iOS users. There are a lot of cool features within Adobe Rush that will expedite your video editing process. But one of the things that I really like about this app is that it gives you options to tailor your video to the platform you'll be publishing it to. In other words, if you're posting to Facebook, it will help you scale your video to the optimal size for Facebook, as well as Instagram, LinkedIn, and others. There are a lot of reviews for these apps on YouTube and tutorials within the apps themselves to help you get started. So I won't get into how to use it, but I do want to recommend them to you as simple but capable video editing tools. Now, if you're someone who feels more comfortable editing video on a desktop rather than a phone, here's another option I would suggest looking into, and this one is fairly new to the industry. It's called Descript. Now, the cool thing about Descript is it allows you to import your video, automatically caption it into a transcript, then edit the video by editing the transcript. Imagine editing a Word document, and as you edit the text, it's automatically editing your video to match. That's pretty cool, right? Most of you will be more familiar and comfortable editing text in a Word document, so this is probably a very appealing option. It's also very cost-effective, with a free option to start and a very reasonable monthly price if you find yourself producing more video content. And I hope you do. So there are three options for you to consider when it comes to editing the video that you're shooting: iMovie, Adobe Rush, or Descript. Obviously, there are a lot more options out there, both for your phone and your desktop, but I know looking into all those options can be very overwhelming, and it's a surefire way to experience a classic case of paralysis by analysis. The last thing you want is to shoot your video, then sit on it because you have no idea where to start when it comes to actually editing it. So these are three possible starting points for you, and I'd encourage you to check these three first to see if one is a good fit for you. Again, keep it simple. The simpler your video, the simpler your edit, and the sooner you'll be able to get your video online to the right spot for the right people to see it. If you're looking for more tips for shooting or editing your own video, make sure to sign up for my weekly email newsletter at joshuakingmedia.com. Each week, I send tips as well as inspiration and some examples to inspire you to shoot your own simple but effective videos. When you sign up, you also get my free guide to 52 video ideas, which translates to a video idea for every week of the year. And each one not only is simple to shoot, it's simple to edit as well. So head to joshuakingmedia.com/email to sign up, get the guide, and get on my email newsletter. I hope to see you there.